Hey, bad buddies, Paul Roberts, artsy one. That last video was so stupid. I can't believe there were so many people interested in it. So it's inspired me. I'm gonna go ahead and make a more micromanaging, stupid little video and see if anybody likes it. Remember when I was telling you a few videos back about the little globules on the top of the ears? This video is gonna be only about how to shape the top of the ears, just to test and see if anybody really cares about this crazy stuff about carving latex on a cowl already in existence. You surprise me sometimes, bad buddies, but that's fun. That's what keeps it fun for me. I was gonna do this anyway, and because you're interested, I'm gonna do it on the camera. It'd be a short video. Here we go. Let's go to the table. Hey, I just said table and nothing happened. Hello?
Table!
I like that one. All right, so here we go, bad buddies. Real simple video. I'll just do one, because they're both the same. Doesn't matter what size the globule is, the technique's the same. How should we do this? Let's go up top. Pay no attention to that man behind the curtain. Or the blood. Okay. Yeah, who says I don't put my blood, sweat, and tears into this? Yeah, I usually just take this head out of here. And I'll go through several steps, and I'll show you the steps I usually go through. Any big globules, I just simply trim off like that. And I try to make sure I've got the right direction going with the scissors. If I'm a little bit off, it doesn't matter. That's the great thing. Latex is so forgiving. I can make mistakes and I can just fix it if I do. So I'm not really worried about it. I don't normally think about talking to people in the video when I do this, but it shouldn't be that hard. Okay. Go around and get that off like that. And then I'll choose. I'll say, well, what's it look like? Should I go with this first? I'll say, yeah, pretty good. You get a little air hole on there like that, it doesn't matter. Because you're gonna fill that in. This is like the second stage of the process, and there's a number of stages. So I figured, if you liked that video the other day, maybe you'll like this stupid little video. So this is stage one, almost to the shape you need already. Flip it over. This just does like a rough beginning job. Now you can also do this with the sander, but you know, I'm not in a rush, and this will do it. Slow but sure. I actually sent somebody a call one time, and they said the ears weren't exactly the same size. So I'll look at them. I'll say, okay, all right. Get exactly the same size ear. All right, I'll generally take this and I'll look at it from the side and I'll bring it down so it's like we were showing the cheek of that cowl the other day. We'll bring it down so it's all the same. And I'll do that from every angle. Once I can see where I hit it, look at that. Blood, sweat, and tears the whole way through this. I'm gonna keep it, man. I'm not gonna keep cleaning up. I want you guys to know the pain I go through sometimes. I'm not even sure how I got that. It was during the starting of this video, though. Maybe moving stuff around, getting ready, I don't know. And then sometimes I'll come along and I'll go, okay, flatten that out. I don't know if you can see this very well, but it's okay. You get the idea. Give me a quick little video. Look at my t-shirt. My t-shirt always looks like this. I go through so many t-shirts. They're cheap. Yeah, I look like I'm always wearing the same shirt, but no, it's pretty much always a different shirt. I've already got a spot of blood on this one. So once I know that's just about what I want, I'll switch back over. Oh, I'm getting sticky. I'm sticking to my Dremel here. I'll go back and I'll just clean it up because I know I've got the planes correct now, okay? So I'm just gonna go back and clean it up a little bit. Just let it run over. Any high spots will come down. Any non-smooth spots will come off. Once it's just about there, there's only one step and you know what it is. It's the little old trusty check it out, see what you got. Yeah. Make sure I get it as close as I can at first. And then the check it out, see what you got step. This check it out, see what you got step is also a step where you're gonna get a little bit of work done on it too. You're gonna burnish this and any little inconsistencies are going to go away. Now this is an irregular cowl. I'm actually doing a replacement for someone and I'm actually calling it an irregular cowl and he knows that's what it is. I don't try to do irregular cowls, but sometimes I have them, and I'll offer it to a bat buddy because, you know, if I have to do the stuff to bring it up to speed, it takes me a lot of time. So sometimes I'll just offer an irregular cowl, and they'll just say, oh, it's good enough, or they'll do it, whatever. So I had an air bubble in this one, okay? This one's almost there. So all I've really got to do to this cowl, let's go back out front. All right, so basically, I've got just this little, when I folded it over, there was an air bubble in there. I didn't realize it. So basically, all I'm gonna do is take this little thing and just squish out some latex inside there. Make it solid. Just force it down in there. Swipe the excess away. And I'm not going to show you the other part on this video, but basically the last part is just to go over it one last time and just do some minute detailing of anything that was slightly off. And you can see from when we started, it was really bad. You can just imagine how much easier it would be to just take about 3 minutes and finish this now the next time I do it. There, another stupid little video on a small little thing. Let's see if anybody likes it. Talk to you later, bad buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One.